Immigration is one of the hottest topics in the nation right now, and right here in Utah, we are at the center of that discussion. Joining us today to talk about immigration is one of the nation's leading immigration attorneys, Charles Cook. He goes by Chuck, so we'll start there. Chuck, thanks for joining us.
Great to be with you.
Now, you spoke with the Capital Club this morning, and everyone just blown away by some of the information you presented there. I think I want to start by asking, why is immigration such a hot topic now? Why is it at a boiling point right now?
People are frustrated. Constituents of politicians are frustrated. They feel that the federal government has done nothing on immigration. They see the consequences of undocumented immigration in their communities. They see hospitals that fill up with emergency rooms. They see more kids in school. And they're feeling the impact locally rather than nationally. So they want something done. And the people they have the best access to are their local politicians.
We talk about people coming to the U.S. illegally. What is the legal route? I don't know that anyone really understands. What's the legal way to get here? What's that like?
There isn't one. No, just kidding. There is a legal route, but it's very difficult. Right now, for example, if I wanted to bring my spouse from Mexico as I was a permanent resident, there'd be a 9-year wait. If I'm a scientist at the University of Utah, I'm from China, I'm working in nuclear technology, and I want a green card today, I have to wait 7 years for that green card. If I want somebody to work for me on my farm, basically there is no line. It's an endless wait. So the reality is our legal immigration service is broken, and because it's broken, we have illegal immigration.
So doesn't this really become a balance between, if illegal immigration is regarded as a problem now, don't we want to turn immigration and a foreign workforce that comes into the U.S. into a strategic asset and bring in the type of workers we need when we need them and restrict their access to the country when we don't need them so much?
Immigration needs to be a national security issue, and not in the issue of it being deportation only. Immigration is a national asset. Lazy people don't walk across the desert. People want to come to America, those people we want in America. We have to change our laws so that based upon our economy, when we need workers, we can get them. When we don't need them, we don't get them. But we bring in the right kind of people at the right place at the right time. That is something we are not doing right now.
The discussion seems to be right now two groups, politicians and angry people, people that are angry about the situation. And you talked a little bit today about the importance of the business community having a voice. So what is the proper voice for business in the immigration discussion?
One of the reasons why Congress hasn't moved forward on any immigration reform at all is because it does not hear from the business community. It doesn't hear what they need and what they want right now. Business leaders actually need to be more outspoken and more vocal, not only about the societal issues of immigration, that is illegal immigration, but the need for real, active, positive immigration legislation, whether it's temporary guest worker programs or greater numbers of visas for college-educated people, or whether it's for people working in the fields and in agriculture. Until farmers, business owners, and business leaders speak out, Congress is simply not going to act on this issue.
You talked about the A word, a word that cannot be mentioned, and we'll say it here. I don't know if we have to bleep it out, but amnesty.
Oh my gosh, you said it. You said it.
I know. We'll be fined by the FCC, I'm sure. Thank goodness this is for the blog. Why has that become a dirty word? Is it just a matter of there are different definitions of it depending on who you're talking to? Why is it such a taboo word?
Apparently, forgiveness is bad. This is what I don't understand. The reason it's bad today is because we had an amnesty and it didn't work. We didn't stop illegal immigration to America. So people have it in their mind that amnesty is bad. Well, the reason that didn't work is because it was an improperly written law. That law in 1986 that President Reagan signed did not account for future flow. It didn't tell America what our future immigration would look like. So we legalized people without a fine, without a fee, and basically gave them a green card. And we made employers into immigration agents. But we didn't increase our immigration. We didn't structure it around what America is going to need in the future. We didn't look at what our national security needs would be. And therefore, illegal immigration increased. And that's what we deal with today, is a consequence of a failed amnesty program. But bringing people into the white economy, into the economy of tax-paying citizens, that's what we need to do now. And the only way we're going to be able to do that is to address future immigration needs rather than just living with a broken immigration system.
Obviously, the Arizona law that was passed ratcheted up the discussion on immigration quite a bit. You mentioned today that obviously there are certain parts of that that are unconstitutional.
Clearly.
And from the chamber's perspective, we've been pushing more of a guest worker program. Mm-hmm. You say that's got a difficult road ahead of it as well. So I guess the question becomes, as a state dabbling in something that really is federal law, what can Utah do? What should, in your expert opinion, opinion, our next step be? What should Utah do?
Well, two things. If you want to try to pass some sort of state legislation that affects immigration, you need to focus on not only the enforcement side, but on the benefit side. The problem is, as a state, you can't pass benefits-based legislation. Now, I would have the legislature contact Congress, contact the administration. Would you give us a waiver to try to pass some sort of state legislation for a guest worker program? They may or may not. They may say Congress won't allow it. It's vague about whether it's even possible. Certainly, the legislature can't act without that waiver. I would also have the state look at doing more I-9 enforcement, making sure employers are actually obeying the law. But I think what the state has to understand is that the state legislators can't enforce their way out of this problem. By vilifying a group of people because of one action they took in their life, they're making society different today. We shouldn't be legislating in anger. We should be legislating with ideas, with a positive vision for the future. What I would advocate for the legislature to do is en masse go to Washington, D.C., and meet with Senator Hatch, meet with Senator Bennett, meet with your congressman, and demand that they start immigration reform today, not wait for some sort of attrition to occur when immigrants are going to leave America, because I will promise you that's not going to happen.
So that federal path is the way to go. Let me give you the magic wand. You've got every vote in the House, and you've got every vote in the Senate, and you've got the veto pen or the veto stamp, and you can put it away. You can solve the problem. If you can do that in 30 seconds, what's the answer? What would you do?
This is not like building a rocket to Mars. This is a fixable program. We have serious border enforcement and border security. We have the money set aside to do interior enforcement, where we're looking for people who are undocumented and going after bad employers that are breaking the law. We have a temporary worker program where we need people. We can bring them in when we need them and how we need them. We have a legal immigration system that says you can immigrate to America and you don't have to wait 10 years. And finally, we have a legalization program where people come forward out of the shadows, pay a fine, pay their back taxes, move to the back of the line, and in 8 or 10 or 12 years, get legal status in the United States. It's simple. We just need the political courage to get it done.
Chuck Cook is one of the foremost authorities on immigration in the United States. Chuck, thanks for taking a few minutes with us.
It's a pleasure being with you.